Austria's southernmost border. Alpine police control landmarks and huts and scout for lost hikers. Over there lies Italy. Today, it is closer than ever before. The mountain range down here in Carinthia, which ties Austria to Italy, is called the Carnic Alps. They are not as mighty as the main ridge of the Alps, but they have an astonishing characteristic. They are located between Austria and Italy, connecting the two countries, and they also connect the Alps to the Mediterranean Sea. In addition, the Carnic Alps are a window into the Earth's history. They have stories to tell which date back hundreds of millions of years. And they are also part of a tourist area, quite a special one. Those who venture up into the Carnic Alps will pass from one enchanting Alp to another. And those that remain in the valley will eventually meet the Gile River, flowing alongside the mountains. And because this is Carinthia, there is also a lake to swim in, delightfully warm in summer, glistening with ice in winter. Snow and fun are easily found in the Carnic Alps. Other things require more time, more curiosity, and a fondness for investigation. For example, the rocks and their inhabitants. The wonder of the meadows and some unloved housemates. To get closer to the people and their way of life, you simply need some leisure time and a ticket for the Gile River Valley train, which has been bringing travelers into the world of the Carnic Alps for more than 100 years. The eastern part of the Gile Valley is fairly wide and covered by crops and meadows. The mountains seem to step back elegantly. Then all of a sudden, the valley changes its character. The mountains are very close by. They look straight down on you. The farmhouses cling to the slopes. Every meadow was a battle to create. However, the Lissach Valley is more beautiful than any tourist could imagine. The Lissach Valley continually eases its way along the Carnic Alps into eastern Tyrol, until it gently fades into the Drau Valley. Even though the valley scenery may also be extraordinarily beautiful, the true heroes of this region are the mountains. Because here on the border between Austria and Italy, it is possible to look further back in time than almost any other place on Earth. It was about 180 years ago that the world first became aware of the Carnic Alps, when esteemed pioneers published the first geologic descriptions, which was a heroic achievement at that time. These pioneers were completely on their own. There were hardly any maps, no forest pathways, no alpine shelter, and the only means of transportation was by foot. Geology was something for hardened characters. In a 170-year-old document, a pioneer complains about miserable hostels, about evil leaders, and the pest of the tollkeepers. All these cliffs one says, have exhausted the patience of the geologists and have prevented them from conducting their specific tasks. A geologist had to wear a skirt and wide trousers. Underwear was considered unnecessary. Those who did not want to do without it sewed it into their trousers to keep it from slipping down. In the Carnic Alps, all these efforts were worth the trouble. An endless number of fossil documents from past eras were found. Generations of men and women, with hammer and chisel, succeeded in solving the history of these mountains from tracks in the rock, which at one time ascended out of the sea. ~500 million years ago, a sea existed here, which lasted for an inconceivable 150 million years. During this period, some 1,000 meters of sediment was deposited on the bottom of the sea. Some of these layers originated from the skeletons and shells of marine organisms, cuttlefish, trilobites, bivalves, and snails. Some of it was preserved in a fossilized form, which was the clue for the early explorers that this area had once been covered by an ocean. They found these animal remains only in certain places, and based on the rock formations and the species which were found, they succeeded in imagining how the world might have looked at the time. On this slate are the silvery impressions of burrows made by an extinct marine species that was covered with mud after its death. At some point during these distant eras, the climate changed. It became warmer, coral reefs developed, and the sea was full of colorful life forms. After they died, they sank to the bottom, were covered by mud, and have likewise been preserved for us in a fossilized form. However, different species than before, and of course in various rock horizons. Various eras, various layers, various animals. This was soon clearly recognizable for the early geologists. Impressions of corals and sea lilies. There were still no mountains here until the ravages of the sea, an immense amount of sand, gravel, and mud from the mainland began to slide into the water. At the end, the sea basin was completely filled up. Now everything was altered, compressed, and lifted, and the Carnic Alps developed about 300 million years ago. In comparison, modern man has only been around for 160,000 years. These were the first Carnic Alps, and not the ones of today. Because in the course of these millions of years, they were flattened again by erosion, and parts of them were flooded by the sea once more. To get your bearings, at that time, the sea transgressed from Italy and almost stretched to the Plöcken Pass. Geologists have been able to reconstruct this complex history, the rising and falling of sea and mainland, and the creation and passing of animals from signs in the rocks, which would only be recognized by hikers if they were to stumble across them. Back now to the present and to the eye-catching miracles. In the Leysach Valley lies the meadow of all meadows, a carefully cultivated nature reserve that is hard to beat for its variety, the so-called Musen, the Hill of Flowers. The queen of this meadow scenery, situated 2,000 meters high, is the paradise lily. During her short blooming period, she exudes a fragrant, sweet perfume. Up here, one meets few people. Nevertheless, if somebody appears, they are often doing a strange activity. Like Christian Wieser, who is here on an official mission to catch butterflies. He is one of two official Corinthian zoologists, and what he has captured here is a precious object. Christian Wieser and the Wieseriella. Admittedly, it is really only a grass miner moth, but quite a special one. It was discovered only a short time ago and named after Christian Wieser. His Wieseriella only exists here, on this hill of flowers in the Leisach Valley. Grass miners are not everyone's cup of tea. It depends on whether one is determined to engage oneself in this little jewel. The Wieseriella lives between blades of grass and goes out on its nuptial flight only 2 weeks in the year. They can only be found at this time. Up to now, only a few people have seen live ones. And up until this moment, no one has ever observed them while they are nectaring, not even Christian Wieser himself. It is the diversity that makes a landscape valuable. The more, the better. From the Hill of Flowers down to the Leisach Valley and the Gyle River. It flows through a gorge that is not easily accessible, where geologically speaking, the North African continental plate broke off. To the right of the Gyle lies, if you will, a part of Africa. And to the left, Europe is closer. For fly fishermen, this really doesn't play a role. Carl Zankel has been following the trouts and the graylings here already for decades. He is the fishing supervisor of the river. What this old warhorse has a natural feeling for is the character of the Gyle. And he knows her perfidies. The Gyle is a rapid river, and many visitors and fishermen who come here to us are more used to peaceful rivers. And this is also dangerous, because the rocks under your feet wash away. You have to be careful of how you get on. The Gyle is also very susceptible to heavy rainfall. After every heavy summer rainfall, the water changes color. Tributaries supply debris flow, and then the river is often brown. And now it is green, because there is some loam in the Gyle. In general, the water is crystal clear. Crystal clear as long as thunderstorms don't gather. This is true, of course, not only for the Gyle, but also for the sky above the Gyle Valley. In summer, the valley is often affected by thunderstorms. They happen suddenly and then quickly disappear again. However, the change of light also has its charm. Sometimes, at the right time, the thick cloud cover can be quite enchanting. For Christian Wieser, the right time is night. He still wanders leisurely around Musen, the Hill of Flowers, upon which clouds are now pressing down hard. He wants to penetrate into the world of the night butterflies with the help of eerie light traps. The first butterflies gather in the nets. They are both fascinated and confused by the light. The darkness reveals its creatures. There are elephant hawk moths, some deltoid moths. Species of geometer moths are also already here. It really starts to happen when it gets dark. The sudden appearance of several thousand of these little animals and the beacon of light happens just like that. There is a fox moth, for example. It's really quite a pretty little animal. The caterpillar is completely hairy. You can find it in late summer in the Alpine meadows. Little guys with combed feelers looking to mate have landed in the butterfly's disco. A thick blue bottle, the elephant hawk moth, there he is, taken away from nectaring. If there is really a lot going on, they argue about the seat. This is the third group, the deltoid moths, rather insignificant animals, but if you look at the fine lines, you'll notice the fascinating beauty of every single one. And now, above, a bagworm moth has settled. This is a little male looking to mate. The females construct a case that is worm-shaped. Bagworm moths, elephant hawk moths, and geometer moths, a kind of parallel world which no one really knows about down below in the valley. After all, the Carnic Alps is a region full of such attractive but rarely known living creatures. Most avoid being discovered, although this is not always so. For example, what took place in Birnbaum with just 200 inhabitants in the middle of the Leisach Valley? It was not so long ago, and it must have been a Sunday. Christa Winkler was busy in the woodshed when suddenly this creature stung by a scorpion. Well, the big panic. And afterwards, I went to a doctor who also did not know what it was. He was also quite nervous, of course. My foot was quite swollen and, yes, a little bad and very strange. And afterwards, yes, after 2 days, everything was okay again. A scorpion in Birnbaum. This does not faze the local Birnbaum band, because apart from rare incidents, one lives with these creatures in a peaceful existence. This concerns the common, nevertheless little-known Alpine scorpion. He is only a few centimeters long. His poison corresponds to that of a bee. Life in the precipitous Leisach Valley is not an easy one. Farming and forestry are hard work, and the winter lasts too long. Who has time to pay attention to unusual animals? A privy councillor from Vienna's Natural History Museum has been travelling around the area for many years by motorcycle. His name, Franz Tiedemann. He's discovered a new species of lizard, which at the time was a zoological sensation. Here, the official summary. "20 years ago, we verified the existence of Horvath's rock lizard here, the first finding for Austria, a new species of vertebrate. Horvath's rock lizard, a remarkable fact about which all the locals know well, of course. However, everything takes time. It took Franz Tiedemann years to find out where this lizard actually lives. The answer, apart from a few exceptions, almost exclusively in the Carnic Alps. Their typical habitat is bare rocks, preferably steep and high in altitude, if possible, uncovered for sun exposure, with many fissures, scratches, and niches to be able to hide at any time. They are the world champions of vertical living. The long tail gives it stability. At breathtaking speed, they ascend and descend the rock walls. Horvath's rock lizard is a well-protected rarity. Franz Tiedemann and his colleagues have mapped their habitat and have monitored these animals for many years. The cliffs of the Carnic Alps. They accommodate many small treasures, carrying mountain pastures on their shoulders and reflecting the Earth's past. In certain places, the cliffs are sensationally generous in offering a look into distant ages. The so-called Chillon Avalanche Gorge was already known to past geologists. However, it was only relevant 50 years ago when they were first properly investigating this section. At a length of 60 meters, layer by layer represents whole geological eras, specifically the Silurian time, a unique place worldwide. Due to ongoing research since the late 19th century, the Carnic Alps are one of the best geologically examined areas on the Earth. Here, virtually every single rock has been analyzed. For Earth scientists, there is an interest that still continues to this day. Today one can find out, for example, by pushing a button, whether a rock is magnetized or not. Modern geologists no longer worry about their underwear, but about rechargeable batteries and their GPS satellite connection, which supplies the computer with data. Thus, the accumulated knowledge about the origin of the Carnic Alps gradually became refined and richer in details. A last jump back into past eras. It was 300 million years ago when the first Carnic Alps sank into the sea. At some places on the new coast, there are deposits of a noticeably red rock, which is also eye-catching, even today, to every passerby. Red rock. This is the desert ground. A clue to the fact that at the time, near to the coast, a desert was located, and iron oxide-bearing rocks occurred in a desert-like climate. The northern part of the Gile Valley represented such a desert, while to the south, there was the sea. After more than 200 million years, new mountains formed, and at the end, the whole Alpine chain developed, including the Carnic Alps. The last big change took place during the Ice Age, a mere 20,000 years ago. At that time, the Gile Valley was filled with ice to a height of 2,000 meters. Subsequently, it became warmer. The ice melted and left many impressions, possibly also the Volia Sea, which is as blue as the heavens and situated at a height of 2,000 meters, a trademark of the Carnic Alps. It has existed since the end of the Ice Age, thus for at least 10,000 years. Only a few have ever looked under the surface, where there are no documents from the distant geological past, but from more recent events. An Arctic char. Evidence of an ecological assault committed 25 years ago. Fish which have eradicated the plankton were put here unthinkingly. The slightly yellowish colouring of the water is due to contact with iron oxides, which are dissolved from the surrounding rock. An excursion back to the year 1950. There, the neighbouring hut was renovated, and it seems as if some of the household effects have been washed into the lake. Also, a hearthstone. And even a little bit more. However, the Volhynia Sea also reflects even more dramatic events. The First World War, which was conducted up here between Austria-Hungary and Italy with unmitigated brutality. Barbed wire. Today, nobody can understand the driving force behind this conflict. Out of the differences came commonalities. The inhabitants of the Carnic Alps have never perceived the separation anyway. Whether on this side or beyond the border, they feel linked to each other. And the language plays only a minor role. In particular, in this small village called Timau, only a few kilometers from the Austrian border. In Timau, one speaks in Italian and in German. The German, however, which is directly derived from the Middle Ages, the so-called Tischelbongerisch, Timau is also accordingly called Tischelbong, a rare linguistic island. Tischelbongerisch is difficult to understand the first time you listen to it. After a few minutes, it becomes clearer. For the most part, of course, it is the older people who still speak Tischelbongerisch. But there is also the younger generation. They are aware that being a linguistic enclave means prestige. Velia Plotzner teaches Tischelbongerisch. She sees Timau, its inhabitants and herself without boundaries. Velia is Italian, also Friulian, and Austria lies right in front of her house door. No, there are no more borders. The only ones are the high mountains. One does have to cross these, but this is no border. We Tischelbonger go to work in Austria, and the Austrians come to Tischelbong to eat pizza and pasta schutta. There are no more borders. Timau lies in the shadows of the highest cliffs of the Carnic Alps. There are only a few kilometers to Carinthia. Over there, the Alpine policemen are once again on border patrol. Traveling with a cross-country vehicle soon comes to an end. To get up into the mountains, one can only use skis. To be an Alpine policeman, one must be an Alpine all-rounder, tour guide, mountain guide, deep snow driver, flight rescuer, Boy Scout, avalanche, and weather expert.
Yeah.
Now their task is to hike from hut to hut, to register burglaries and to find people in need. Those who go on patrol up here should have more in mind than just duty. They must really love the mountains, best of all in such a way as the widely travelled Alois Ortner. When I come back from expeditions from all over the world, people ask me where is the most beautiful place. Then I say that the nicest is always crossing the mountain range to see my Gael Valley and the Lesach Valley once again. This was always the nicest moment, and I hope that I will be able to enjoy this for a long, long time to come. Those who seek peace and quiet will find it here. And those who want fun and action, no problem. Nassfeld lies right next door. A ski area for the big and the small, and the place which stands for winter vacation in the Carnic Alps. The Nassfeld area is located on the Italian border, and it is a snowy hole. Here, Austrian precipitation records are compiled, which does not disturb the skiers in winter. A fact that at the beginning of the 60s lured a resourceful thinker here, Arnold Pücher. Actually, I only came here in search of snow. Snow was a big theme at that time, also not just today. And at that time, there were a few meters of snow in the Carnic Alps. There was natural snow. There was no machine snow then. And in the remaining areas, above all, in the main chain of the Alps, snow was not enough. Pücher had a vision, and he had courage. Soon, a road was built up to Nassfeld, and the first hotels were established. A new border crossing opened a gate to Italy. Today, 40 years later, there is no border control. In the beginning, the majority of the ski area at Nassfeld was still idyllic, until a European-wide oral marketing campaign started that one can also count on the sun as much as on the snow here, and that this can be documented even by meteorologists. Lucky for Arnold Pücher. Today, all hell breaks loose in the winter season. The landscape was reshaped in favor of the skiers. What only a few know, the province flower of Carinthia, the Wolfinia, is sleeping underneath the skis. A botanical rarity which blossoms at the end of June and in Europe only prospers in Nassfeld. Thus, Nassfeld illustrates the contrast to the quiet calmness of the remaining region. Oswald Winkler, a gamekeeper, is representative of someone outside the holiday world in the Carnic Alps. His district lies in the Lesach Valley, and in winter, it takes nearly 45 minutes to drive from the main road up to the mountain meadows. In extreme winters, hay is put out for the red deer. Apart from perfectly staged Nassfeld, the Carnic Alps have never been saddled with the dubious Lederhosen image, so favoured by commercial folk musicians and the tourist trade elsewhere. Oswald Winkler is real, just like his mountain meadow, and his hunting lodge, and his deer. Even the silence is genuine. As they look today, the Carnic Alps have only been in existence for about 10,000 years, since the end of the last ice age. It has been about 200 years since scientists began to explore them. Among those pioneers, the geologists were often looked at distrustfully because of their strange activities. It is the same for their great-grandchildren. What looks like preparations for a military expedition is a research assignment. The Army grants administrative assistance. For the scientific implications, the Federal Geological Survey is responsible. The yellow torpedo contains electronic instruments that are flown by helicopter using a grid over mountains and valleys. The geologists measure the Earth's magnetic field with it and the anomaly of the natural radioactivity. There is no real reason for this to be done in the Gail Valley, but maps should be established for the whole of Austria, because one simply wants to know the intensity of the radiation to be prepared for the future. The rattle of the research helicopter has accompanied the daily life of those in the valley for weeks. In time, word is out that it is only the geologists once again. However, in the meantime, they are almost locals. Valley, the march which touches all hearts, the land which is so beautiful, the sun shines. However, cloudy sky is not a foreign word here. Those who want to experience the Gail Valley should forgive the capricious weather and learn to enjoy it. The clouds normally move from the Adriatic to the north until they meet the Italian-Austrian border, the main ridge of the Carnic Alps, where they are forced to hold up. Indeed, this is sometimes bleak, but nevertheless, for the most part, it contributes to the variety. The rain lends vitality to the scenery, and the clouds give structure to the sky. The Mediterranean Sea is only 100 kilometers away. A Mediterranean low-pressure area is easy game, and at the end, the clouds begin to form. With 2 to 3 days of continuous rain, the Carnic Alps holds the Austrian record. The brooks don't start off here as gentle springs, but kick off immediately as small creeks. It's no wonder that 100 years ago, the first small power stations originated here. Meanwhile, the leading supplier of eco-energy in Austria is based in the Gail Valley, one of the highest standing wind generators in Europe. And below, in Kutschach Mountain, energy for half of the community is supplied by a brand new biogas power plant. Where the clouds and the sky are so close, and the earth allows you a glimpse into the history of creation, God certainly has a place. In the Leisach Valley lies Maria Lugau, a 500-year-old place of pilgrimage. And 20 kilometers away is a place where every 10 years a hunter's mass takes place and is hard to beat for the beauty and the atmosphere. People from all over the Leisach Valley meet here. Musicians, farmers, the fire brigade, police, tourists, and hunters. Ladies and gentlemen who have come here today to this holy mass, my dear hunters, I welcome you from the bottom of my heart. The county hunter official appeals for solidarity. One is very conscious of which natural resources the people have to manage and to sustain, so that everyone will benefit, and that the hunters are only one part. Today, everyone has got a little closer to the good things.
Im Namen des Vaters und des Sohnes und des Heiligen Geistes. Amen. Der Herr sei mit euch.
The inhabitants of the Carnic Alps live at a junction of cultures. This world along the border seems to be more colorful, more varied, and edgy than anywhere else.
This is really very scenic anyway.
The tourists provide much of the colorfulness. They are attracted by geological trails, and geologists from all over the world are visiting this famous area.
Okay, welcome you to the first stop of today's morning.
This excursion is attended by 16 scientists from 10 different countries.
Again, at an altitude of more than 1900 meters.
Hans-Peter Schönlaub has worked here for 40 years. He has written hundreds of publications and has initiated the longest geological trail in Europe.
Yeah, you have your lens?
Yeah. Like all of his colleagues, he pursues this glimpse into the history of the Earth with great passion. And in accordance with a motto that one of the forefathers of geology formulated 180 years ago, he advised his readers, "The rocks are your friends. The longer you deal with them, the better you know them. And your joy is more real."
We
If one understands the processes which govern the past, then one can also properly judge processes in the present. This is quite decisive. And the knowledge acquired from here does not only have local significance, but has a global impact, whether it concerns volcanic eruptions or sea level variations or climate change. These have consequences for our daily life. If one understands the past, one can also draw conclusions for today and the future. Carnic Alps, a border mountain range full of hidden jewels, and that puts you in contact with the past. There is only one thing left to describe: how it really feels to live here. This could be hard to articulate, but in Carinthia, in this case, one prefers to sing. A song about the Gael Valley, for example. Of course, from the heart, and naturally from the soul of a Gael Valley girl.
Ich sitz in der Wiesen und sieg die Berg vor mir. Ein Paradies zum Genießen von Herzen, danke dir. Ich leb das seit meiner Kindheit und ich hoff noch einige Jahr. Ein Landschaft so voll Schönheit, für mich ist eins ganz klar. Das Geital ist mein Daheim. So wunderschön, ihr kennt's mir's klar. Mein Herz, mein Soll. Berg oder Bama, die gute Luft noch dazu. So mancher kommt davon träumen und wir stehen gleich davor. Ich weiß es sehr zu schätzen, da im Geital zu leben. Ich könnt mir's auch nicht mehr vorstellen, woanders hinzugehen. Das Geital ist mein. So wunderschön, ihr kennt's mir's klar. Mein Herz, mein Soll hat Heimat gefunden. Ich bleib dem Tal ewig verbunden. Das Geital ist mein Daheim. So wunderschön, ihr kennt's mir's klar. Bleib dem Tor.